guys, welcome back to Budget Love. If you haven't subscribed, quickly do so. Don't forget to like and share this video. So today we are going to be talking about percentage of change. I think it's an amazing concept for you guys to know, to add to your financial literacy education. I think it's important. You're probably going to have to use it at some point in your life. So what is it? So percentage of change, it's comparing two values, all right? So the formula is new minus old over old. New is what the new value is, and old is what the old value is. So once you calculate the formula, if your result if your value is a positive value, your result is positive, then it's an increase. If it's a negative value or result, then it's a decrease. So it's pretty much what it is. So I just have like three examples for you guys, and which I think are real life examples. All right, so the first one is, say you want to invest, okay? So you're looking to invest some money. Of course, before investing, you have to do your research, okay? So say you want to buy Budget Love shares. Not that we have any shares, but I don't know. All right, so you want to buy Budget Love shares. So you go in, you're doing your research, and you notice that on the 25th, the price was $10. Okay, so it's $10, and then you're looking at today's, which is the 26th. So you're like, oh, okay, well, right now it's $15. So you're trying to figure out, clearly you can see that the difference is $5, but you're trying to see what the difference is in percentage wise. Okay, so you go and do your calculation. 15 minus 10, which is 5, and then you divide that by 10, which gives you 0.5. And then you multiply that by 100, then you get 50%. So in just one day, the price of the Budget Love share increased by 50%. So then you can kind of like determine whether you want to go ahead and invest in that company, or you want to keep looking around and see if there's something better, if something that you want to do. All right, so. My second example is, okay, let's say you have, you're looking at colleges, okay, or universities, and you're looking at colleges, and, okay, so you're doing your research, okay, so you notice that in 2019, for Budget Love University, Budget Love University, right, in 2019, the tuition was $30,000. Okay, and then in 2020, it's $37,000. So you're trying to figure out, okay, what is it in percentage-wise? Okay, so then you go ahead and do your formula. So $37,000, which is the new value, minus $30,000, which is the old value, and then you divide it by the $30,000, which is also the old value, and then you get 0.23, multiplied by 100, then you get 23%. Okay, so you're like, in just a year, the tuition increased by 23%. Okay, well, colleges and universities, people usually go for 4 years. So, well, if you get your bachelor's. But, so if you want to, like, kind of predict what the tuition is going to be in 2021, you can say that, okay, well, since it increased by 23% in 2020, well, let me figure out if it's going to be, like, how much it's going to be in 2021. So then what you do is, that's 37%, multiply it by 22%, and then you get $8,510. So that's how much the tuition is going to increase by in 2020. So then you add that to the $37,000, and then you get the new tuition of $45,510. So, and then you can kind of do that the next year to see like how much
it's going to be in 2022, just to kind of, like, estimate and, you know, like, if you're saving money, like, to see how much money you need to save to cover those tuition expenses. All right. Third example. Let's say Nina. Oh, Nina. So Nina is in debt, but her goal is to be financial. Like, she wants to be debt-free. No more debt. She's stressed out. She doesn't want to have any more debt anymore. It's just too much for her. And she decided that she's going to start paying some of her debt. So she's going to do it. She's going to have a book. She has goals. So right now, her total debt is $100,000. So she says by the end of 2020, she wants to pay at least, she wants her new debt balance to be $93,000. So, but she's trying to see, like, percentage-wise, how much is that? So now, she goes into the formula, and then she does $93,000 minus $100,000, which is the old value, because that's what she wants. Her debt to be $93,000, which is the new value. $100,000 is the old one. Divide that by $100,000, which is the old one, and she gets negative 0.07. Then you multiply that by 100, then she gets 7%, negative 7%. Her result is a negative result. So that means that it's a decrease, because she's trying to decrease that $100,000 to $93,000. So then we're just saying that, okay, well, by the end of 2020, her debt will be decreased by 7%. All right. I hope you can find these examples useful. And if you have any questions about anything else, comment them below. If you have any examples that you want me to look at, you can definitely comment them below. I hope you like this. It's very simple, not hard. Alright, that's all I have for you guys today. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Alright, bye guys.